Just the other day she couldn't stop, she wouldn't stay and talk with me. I met her then the other week and she was kind.
Obviously a key element as well, particularly for ships that aren't familiar with the port, the master needs the assistance of a pilot. A pilot is one of our staff that goes out to the ship to advise the master about the peculiarities of the port. And the harbour master has to make sure that there's a pilot boat there to get the pilot out on time and everything else. So all that takes a lot of coordination.
Pilots are basically here for local knowledge. They have an in-depth knowledge of the tidal streams, the weather conditions, all the berths, and they can safely navigate the ship in. They're there to assist the captain of the ship or the master of the vessel in, because as you can understand, most of them are coming from far off parts, don't know where they've been. And they don't know the port, so they will assist them in. They will assist the master to get the ship alongside. And being a large bulk carrier that we have coming up now, being over 200 metres, it's going to be tricky. So he'll have to talk with the tugs, he'll liaise with me, and we'll organise the traffic around him.
Dublin Port is the single biggest distribution centre in the country, with 9,000 trucks passing through the port every day. The majority of these will now be able to access the motorway network directly through the tunnel, rather than through the city centre. The tunnel offers many opportunities for the future, and these will be further enhanced as Dublin Port itself is developed in the years ahead.
Well, we're a 24/7 operation, 365 days of the year, and we have people on duty here all the time, pilots, marine staff, our maintenance staff. Administration is not done on a 24-hour basis, but we have 162 very hard-working people here in this organisation, keeping Dublin Port running.
Dublin Port and the City of Dublin are sort of an integral unit, and that's not unusual. It happens all over the world, ports like Hamburg, Vancouver, where the city and the port work together and get on very well. But what many people in the city and the environs don't appreciate is just what goes on down here and how dynamic this place is. For example, we have about 13,500 truck movements in and out of this port every day. We have about between 3,000 and 4,000 people working this estate every day. So there's an awful lot of movement in and out of the port. I think a few years ago that would probably have had a negative impact on the people of the city, because they would have seen all these trucks thundering up to the quays and everything else. Thankfully, since the port tunnel has been built, that problem has been alleviated, so we don't see as many trucks now in the city. So while this is a great benefit in the city, the people in the city are unaware of what's going on in the port, because where the trucks are moving before, they knew where they were coming from. Now that there are no trucks up there, they really don't know what's going on down here in the port. And as we've shown you, it's a vibrant part of our economy, very, very dynamic part, but there's absolutely nothing or unusual in having a city and a port working together like we have here.
Dublin Port has always been part of the city, and whereas in other places in the world the harbour has moved to the outskirts, in Dublin it's only a couple of kilometres away from the city centre.
Dublin Port has always been an integral part of the community, with employment mainly. And of course, using the ferries and such for social activities and for immigration. In latter years, the role has changed in relation to the community. They're more aware now of being a good neighbour.
They're very supportive of some of the projects within the communities around us, surrounding the port. Very helpful. Anything you need, the port will always be there to help out. I mean, they're very, very good neighbours to us.
Dublin Port awards scholarships now to local kids, leaving cert students, to go to third level. So that's a way that our younger people will benefit from the relationship with the port. Well, it's ours. It's ours. It's Dublin Port.
Yeah.
That's just ours. Yeah. The same as Pier Square is ours. The same as Weston Road Church is ours. Yeah. It's just part of us.
Yeah.
And yeah. It's just part of us.
I think the port is Dublin.
I want to be here with you till the morning dew comes forth.
People drive by Dublin Port along East Wall Road daily, and they probably don't recognise or realise that 31 million tonnes of cargo come in and out of this port annually, and that it is in fact the largest port. So we don't impinge on people to that extent. And of course we also have one of the finest bird sanctuaries in the world very close to us here, and we live quite close by it and we get on quite well with it. That's Bull Island, which wouldn't be here unless the walls were built by Dublin Port Company or its predecessors.
Staff are not the only people to pass through the port on a daily basis. Six ferry companies operate up to 18 sailings daily to the UK from Dublin Port. There's never been a better time to travel by sea. Faster, more comfortable ships, equipped with state-of-the-art facilities, are ferrying more and more passengers to and from Dublin Port.
We're going to see Manchester play against Blackburn. Really looking forward to it at Old Trafford. It's going to be brilliant. A lot more stress-free, really. I really enjoy just being on the ferry. It's really convenient. Like, I live in the city centre and it's really close by. Just the stress of going on the airport compared to this, it just doesn't compare. And get to walk around on the ferry and have a good time with your friends. It's just, I really prefer this way of travelling.
The economy of Ireland relies hugely on the ports, because 99.5% by volume of the trade coming into the state comes through the ports. Only a very small amount of it comes by air. So it's hugely dependent upon the ports, and indeed hugely dependent on Dublin Port, because 42% of all the trade in and out of this country, and again a country which is hugely dependent upon international trade, 42% of that comes through Dublin Port.
Well, we in Dublin Port Company are very, very aware that the role of the port is absolutely critical in terms of national and regional economies. We are a link in the supply chain, and without us the economy will grind to a halt in this area in a very, very short time. So many jobs, so much livelihood, success of so many businesses, that the ability of people to plan their businesses and everything else depends on us doing our job, and we feel proud that we're doing that. But it is absolutely critical to this economy that goods, and this is what we've got to concentrate on. Our economy depends on the movement of goods. We feel that we play a major role in making sure those goods move efficiently around the country.
People are walking through shopping centres like Liffey Valley. They don't realise that 15 years ago these shopping centres weren't there. So that was part of the growth of Dublin Port. They also may not realise that most of the goods they see, the shoes, the white goods, the books that they purchase, come through Dublin Port.
I'm walking down that long road with a smile upon my face. Broken heart.
If we were to close today, the economy would grind in this area would grind to a halt very, very quickly. For example, we are the main supplier of fuel to Dublin Airport. And if we stopped operating, because of the limitations of storage at Dublin Airport, the airport would close in 3 days. Now, obviously, a lot of the supermarkets, warehouses, work on what's called a just-in-time delivery system. In other words, instead of having warehouses all over the place, we'll rely on these goods arriving at a certain time. And if we stopped, that reliance is gone. And you would see the shelves in the supermarkets drying up very, very quickly. So we'd all be finding our nappy liners and all the other bits and pieces would start disappearing off the shelves within a couple of days.
All right, so you don't sympathize. Don't expect that you should, but stay bright for one day. You might run into this patch of gray cloud too. Gravel in my pockets for the places I have been. The souls are my
this port is non-stop. You go 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, because shipping, there's no clock on a ship, you know, it just keeps going. It does.
Dublin Port is the cleanest, greenest and most efficient way of getting your goods to the market. That's why Dublin Port is the biggest port in the country and is the port of first choice for most exporters and importers.
So there you have it, an insight into the economic behemoth that is Dublin's port. Nestled away in the heart of the city, Dublin Port has been the engine room of Ireland's trading and industrial activity.